An electrical air pump usually used to treat asthma is at the centre of a COVID-19 outbreak at a managed isolation hotel in Melbourne. 10 cases are now being linked to an infected guest who used a nebuliser. Doctors there call the devices COVID spreaders and they're banned from Australian MIQ facilities. But as Logan Church reports, that's not the case here.
Guests evacuated, this Melbourne quarantine hotel shut down. The Holiday Inn by the city's airport, the centre of a new COVID-19 outbreak.
These hyper-infectious strains are proving very difficult to contain.
An infected guest using a nebuliser blamed for the cluster.
It really vaporises medication or liquid, meant that the virus was carried out into the corridor.
The user now in intensive care, health officials now in damage control.
The medical community knows full well that these particular devices are really COVID spreaders. The fact that one of these machines could get into the hotels in the first place is disconcerting.
10 cases have been linked to the hotel, 3 workers, 2 residents who left 2 days ago, a family of 3, and 2 more revealed this afternoon.
All these cases should be investigated, and with a specific focus, what is the airflow in this hotels and how that airflow could have transmitted the virus from one place to another.
The New Zealand Ministry of Health say nebulizers can be used at managed isolation and quarantine facilities here if they are part of a returnee's medication and clinical staff assisting them use full PPE. But experts here say the Melbourne hotel outbreak is revealing cracks in the hotel quarantine system.
These environments are problematic. They're just not designed for proper infection control. And so that's why we need to investigate alternatives, and especially in the situation where the virus seems to be getting more infectious.
Meanwhile, South Australia isn't taking any chances, shutting its border to Melbourne residents. Other states also on high alert, with fears infected people may have already crossed state lines. Logan Church, One News.